What's up? It's NC here with another episode of Pokemon Battle Zone. I lead off with Simisage? Yes, people. I'm using a Simisage. Can you believe it? This is actually debuting a new team I'm using, and it's actually been pretty good so far. But it has a Simisage. I just saw it, and I thought, you know what? I never see Simisage. So you know what? I'm going to use one. And I actually have enjoyed using it so far as well. My opponent leads off with a Ninetales. Okay. That's pretty cool. I don't see you so much now since Jolt got nerfed. Ah, such a shame. Ninetales, you're awesome in my eyes. It's such a shame that your ability was pretty much the only reason people used you. Oh well, at least you still got Jolt to use in its current state. But he brings in his Exeggutor. And of course, because I'm still Choice Scarfed, I do outspeed him this turn and go ahead and use whatever move it was I did use. Sorry, I was too busy reminiscing over Ninetales. I think it was Flare Blitz. Actually, it was Flare Blitz because he used Focus Sash. So I bring back in my Simisage and he's now going to bring in Umbreon. And he goes for the Protect, and that's going to be pretty bad for me because he now knows I carry the Focus Blast. Mind you, it might not have hit anyway since Focus Blast is pretty much the only fighting special move that Simisage learns. Really could do something better like Aura Sphere or something along those lines. But I do actually do hit with the Focus Blast, which did surprise me. So I go for another Focus Blast and it actually hits. I can't believe that. I honestly never do that. I never hit with two Focus Blasts at once. Just too bad I'm going to get KO'd by Fire Blast. Oh well, whatever. So, I lose my Simisage. Sorry buddy, but you'll get more action in future videos. So, I'm now going to bring in my Arcanine, and here comes more Intimidate. We had enough Intimidating in the last episode. I tell you, Krokodile must be well happy. His counter's going up like crazy. So, I'm now going to watch him switch into Umbreon, and I go for the Extreme Speed. What the hell was that? Seriously, what the hell was that? Well, I'll tell you what it was. It was me extreme speeding into a rocky helmet to kill myself. Yeah, that's what I did. So, I bring in my Gallade and in comes... Whoa! Look at that. Just look at that. Look at that fantastic Mega Evolution. This is probably my favorite Mega of all time. I know there's some pretty awesome Megas out there, but I think Mega Gallade is my favourite Mega. It just looks so amazing. It gets a cape. That's enough said. I love this thing so much. Maybe even more than Ninetales. Okay, from now on, I shall be Mega Gallade Commander.
That doesn't exactly roll off the tongue.
You got a good point there. Oh well, I'll stay as Ninetales. So he's now going to bring in his Exeggutor, which doesn't really bother me because I have the infamous Shadow Sneak, and that's going to put an end to the battle. So I just KO'd all three of his opponent's Pokemon with just one freaking Mega Gallade! Ha ha ha! Feel the power of the Caped Crusader!
Don't make this worse for yourself.
Fine. Man, it is so hard to make people laugh these days. So, into the second battle. I lead off with my Vaporeon, they've got a Dusclops. I go straight in for the Toxic because Dusclops is actually pretty good at taking hits, especially with Eviolite, which is probably what every Dusclops user is going to use. But he goes for the Confuse Ray. Okay. Right, whatever. So, because of Toxic, I can now get a bit of damage at the end of every turn for myself. I'm now going to switch out and go into my Tornadus. And fortunately for me, he ends up going straight in for the Will-O-Wisp, which does make me take damage at the end of every turn, but on the bright side, I'm not going to be hindered in terms of attacking, because I am a special attacker. Yep, I am a special attacker. And I really should get one of these and nickname it Lakitu, because he looks just like Lakitu from Super Mario Bros. So I go straight in for the Dark Pulse, which makes me think, why didn't I just do that right away? Then again, if I did it on the first turn, I would have ended up with a Confused Thundurus, which may have made the match go differently. Good thing I didn't. So, I take some burn damage, he's going to bring in his Garchomp. I'm going to go straight in for the Air Slash. Pretty sure this will not KO, because Garchomp does have pretty good defenses, but he does take a good chunk of damage. He's not going to go for Earthquake? I'm going to assume that was a misclick, or he was predicting a switch to something else, but whatever. So I go for an air slash, and that's going to result in another KO, and that's now going to make me take some more burn damage as well as my life orb damage. Now he's going to bring in, I believe, his last Pokemon, which is Gengar. I think this is his last Pokemon, but it transforms into Mega Gengar, and yeah, another Mega Gengar, then I'm just going to KO a Dark Pulse. Yeah, that I got nothing. I literally got nothing. I win. So, thanks for watching. Bye.
That was a nice distraction.